hot dogs, it ain't no limits. Put your head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Money on my mind, head in the game. It's like
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State and TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Chicago Bears and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And not much on this one. Takes it from the 21. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Looking to pass on the first play. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. Looking downfield for Jones. And this one is incomplete. The Jaguars at a perfect 4-0 to start the campaign. They've been playing their best football of the year, winners of four in a row.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Hey, exit. Hey, Delta.
Lawrence will throw. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Well, I certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
So now third and 10. They had the big play to start the drive, but two incompletion sets. Now Lawrence to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. That will pick up a 15 for Jacksonville. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Lawrence. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. You're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Throwing again here, it's Lawrence. Escaping the pressure right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. That one a pickup of 15 for Jacksonville.
This early in the game, it's all about making steady progress downfield, hoping to lead to early points. And you can do it with your actual play calls or sometimes something a little more improvised, as we just saw there.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he's going to hook up with his big tight end. Complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
Throwing again on second down, Lawrence. It's caught at the 7-yard line. And the Jags are going to have a first and goal. They nearly had the touchdown, but he's going to be marked out of bounds just shy of the pylon. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Robinson is not going to get in. In fact, he'll lose a couple of yards back to the 3. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
Sometimes I think these defensive tackles get a little bit of a bum rap. We just see them as big guys that eat up blockers for others to make tackles. Oftentimes they're quicker than they get credit for. And this time he uses quickness to make a play.
Second down and goal. Lawrence, back of the end zone. Could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
Now we got third and goal coming up, and couldn't you imagine being in that huddle, partner? You know they're looking at each other saying, we can't come away with just 3 points after this drive.
Yeah, they've covered a lot of ground. They want more than that 3. This Bears defense trying to hold on. This is third and goal. Here's Lawrence to throw. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Trevor Lawrence, touchdown number 18 on the year. And the Jags put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Remember
what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to prove in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
To the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Try and start this drive in the air. Out left and hauled in by Ortega Whiteside. Finding space at the 40. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. The big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Flushed out right. That's complete to Swift out of the backfield. Gets past one man. Still going. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. The offense has to love that because that was just a dump down, and then he turned something out of seemingly nothing.
And the best quarterbacks understand that dumping it down is often a good play, a better play than even what was drawn up.
Now Here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver.
And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
They'll run with Swift. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Big play forthcoming. Here's 3rd and goal. They'll look to throw here. This will be caught at about the 5. They're able to hold him to 3 there. That leads to a 4th and goal.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on 3rd down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a 1st down.
And not only will he not get in, he's going to lose yardage. They stuff him back at the 4. The run is turned away on 4th and goal from the 2. And the Jaguars are able to come up with a goal line stand. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. We're just 2 series in here, Charles, but everything's gone to script so far. They got a touchdown on their 1st drive. Their defense holds, and now they've got a chance to take a 2-score lead.
And to co-sign with you, exactly the start they scripted up. And really, that kind of start, that can set the tone for the game for them.
And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. To throw again on 2nd down, Lawrence, and he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Slot man moves right.
Hey, stand up. Hey, exit.
On 3rd down, Lawrence. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And they take this up near the 30 before he's taken down. That's a 3rd down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
And that's a much-needed completion right there on 3rd down. Really a sigh of relief, isn't it? They're backed up deep. You know they don't want to give the ball back to the other guys. A great field position. They needed that throw, that completion, that 1st down. I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his 5th catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. From the 31, Lawrence. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up 3rd down. But to throw again is Lawrence. Throws right side, and that's complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another 1st down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on 3rd down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot and they connected there and picked up a first down.
On first and 10, it's Lawrence. He's got a man complete. It's a big play for the Jaguars. 42 yards.
You can feel the effort all the way up here. He tried his best to get there. Didn't quite make it, but down around the 2-3 yard line, gotta love the effort, and especially the big play that gave his offense a great opportunity.
And they'll run with ETN.
Nothing doing there. They're gonna wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's gonna set up second and goal.
One more time with ETN.
And he'll take this into the end zone. A touchdown, Jacksonville.
Travis Etienne, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Jaguars go coast to coast and finish the drive off with 6 points. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. On the return, it's Tristan Ebner from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year. Let alone back-to-back weeks. I'll tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit.
They'll start on the ground with Swift. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down.
And that run was memorable for only one reason. There was absolutely no place to run with the football. No gaps, no creases, no gain.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He gets this to Devontae Adams. The 20. Touchdown, Chicago. Devontae Adams. 75 yards.
And the Bears get a late score here in the final minute of the first half.
Extra point splits the uprights, and they'll cut the lead to 21-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20.
And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive.
And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not to try and put a late scoring drive together. finding ETN here, catching it on the out route. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Good work after the catch, gets him 15 and a first down. Now Lawrence. Now he lets it go deep for Kirk. Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Christian Kirk in the final seconds of the first half. And the Jaguars would extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by the Dolphins, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together.
Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter.
They'll throw now on the final play.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
I mean, at this point, CD, what is not going their way in this first half? After that pick six, they now have a 4-possession lead here.
And that allows them to say to themselves, how about we get everybody involved, okay? Because this one is a runaway. And it's looking like it's going to be even more of a runaway. Everybody gets a chance to play and get a little bit of love. The more guys that get to watch the highlight reels from this one, the better.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3 alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon.
The Bears going to see the football first, and they trail here as we get back underway to start this second half.
And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. A CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history. Let's try to come back from a 4-possession deficit.
And partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late, that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible in this possession.
And for the third time tonight, he's intercepted.
And the Jaguars are going to take possession of the football.
Well, I certainly think that we're seeing a big reason why this team has struggled to put points on the board so far, because too many of their drives have ended in turnovers already, and we still have almost a full half of football yet to play.
Now Lawrence on first down. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by James Bradbury.
And the Bears are going to take over at their own 2-yard line.
Well, to be blunt, not a whole lot has gone right for this defense in this ball game, but that's something right there still in the third quarter. It would take something around miracle territory for a comeback, but maybe that's a start, Charles.
It certainly is, and they're definitely showing that there's some fight still left in them. Hasn't been a banner day. They're trying their best to put that disappointment behind them and find ways to make plays. That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Now it's second and 9.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw.
right back to Tony. He's got another one. Finding space at the 40. Now he's loose at the 40. Kadarius Tony. Touchdown, Chicago. Kadarius Tony, 97 yards. And the Bears are able to make some inroads here to that deficit.
Well, if they're going to make a game of this in the second half, they need a few big plays to go their way. That's one.
And the way to get it done is to also conserve time. So to your point, that big play right there, now you're not moving the ball downfield, taking time off the clock. You're leaving yourself a better avenue to continue to try and make a comeback.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From just inside the 20, a short kick. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Still operating with a comfortable lead despite the score a moment ago as they begin first and 10. Buying time to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. To throw again on second down, Lawrence. He'll air this one out for Kirk. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. Touchdown, Jaguars. McLaughlin for the extra point. And that'll increase their lead to 28. To the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Ebner going to elect to bring this out of the end zone here. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. But we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD. And if they, and for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. As confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Ebner going to elect to bring this out of the end zone here. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles. But I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something.
There he goes, left side. 30, 10, 5, touchdown, Chicago. Devontae Adams. His 104th career touchdown, one shy of Tim Brown on the all-time list. And the Bears are able to at least get one score back. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll cut the lead down a bit to 28. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. A short kick taken at the 18. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive. still well in control of this ball game despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago. A throw left side to start out. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. On first down, Lawrence. Pressure, and he's taken down. A bear sack. Tanner Muse in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
Pressure can come from all over when you're plotting a defensive strategy. On that particular play, it just came from the outside.
Throwing on second and long. Lawrence. Over the middle, complete. It's Jones. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies X.
This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown. A great play there. 56 yards. And the Jaguars get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that lead. Extra point by McGuire is up and good. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. Ebner going to elect to bring this out of the end zone here. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
Well, this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one, after we saw that first turnover, we worried that things would snowball, and it certainly did, especially on the scoreboard.
So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and it'll be a third and about 13.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first. They'll look to throw. And my goodness, another interception. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
Well, whatever adjustments they're trying to make over on that sideline, Charles, this defense, they just seem to be a step in front of them and not giving them a chance to implement any of those changes. And here, a pick six, and they widen the lead.
At least a step ahead, maybe even 2 steps. And right now, they're thinking hard about putting this opponent away. That turnover, it grew their lead and just totally deflated that offense. Now these next couple of series, you can take them out of the game entirely if you continue on this pace.
At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
It's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point, Charles. And one reason is turnovers. A turnover on the last drive. They had the issue in the first half as well. And that's really, unfortunately for them, helped to put this game out of reach.
And you know they won't admit it to themselves, but we know that winning the game is pretty much out of the picture now. So their bottom line is, how do they play a clean game the rest of this one, right? Take care of the football, no more turnovers.
And now here's another interception.
Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. On the counter, ETN. And he'll get about 3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. Another tote for ETN. And he's taken down at the seven after a gain of seven.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more of a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
I think we got to give it up for him right there. That's a heck of an athletic move for a big man right in the middle of the line. How about the play he makes there? Nowhere to run, and he finishes that one off for a loss.
They're going on fourth down. Lawrence. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Jags come up empty on fourth down, and the Bears will get the football back. A little jet sweep to start the drive. And he'll go down for a loss inside his own 5 at the 4.
The defensive coordinators love that. You got a cornerback willing to stick his nose in there, come up on run support, and stop that pop pass dead in its tracks.
And partner, one good thing about trying to defend that play, you should see it coming the whole way. You see the receiver coming in motion in your direction.
And it's intercepted in the end zone. Picked up by Fuliasade Amuleke.
Well, what has been a fantastic game for this defense has been rough for this offense. And certainly a signal caller, Charles. It's thrown all these interceptions. Another one there, and this one taken all the way back for the score.
Nice in the post-game highlights to show this rip of interceptions and great plays this group has made. They've been on it from snap one.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. They'll drop the throw. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. He couldn't get away. He wound up losing a dozen yards, a 12-yard loss, and it brings up third.
We all know he's one of the better quarterbacks in the league, but definitely not today. His team trailed by multiple touchdowns and a late sack. Just a parting gift from the defense for him to take back to the locker room with him.
The Bears on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This will be third and a mile. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away. And he can't.
Another throw to Mark. Obviously, he's battled all the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question, and my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence.
And my goodness, another interception. And the Jags are going to take possession of the football.
Yet another mistake after the interception there. And guys, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1 yard pickup. Sets up third and six.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
You got bombers. Hey, exit. Go, 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 go. Go, go.
Here's Lawrence. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. Fourth down, here's Lawrence. There's that man again. It's complete. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. A shotgun snap and a give to ETN. And he's able to get it down to the 2 yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job, and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
This will be play number 7 on the drive. Third and a yard. Down to a knee for the Jags. Victory seemingly in hand. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game.
Hey, Delta. Hey,
And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. McLaughlin now to add the PAT. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. From the 10. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds. They've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind?